Growing up, I had dreams and aspirations, but always felt like the kid that didn't fit in. For the most part, I wasn't a bad kid, but when I made the transition into adulthood, I turned to the streets for guidance. This led to getting locked up in juvenile hall, doing time in CYA, and eventually a 120-month sentence in federal prison. I had a lot of time to think and reflect during my federal sentence. So I share with you what I learned, hoping I can positively influence someone else's life with Prison Talk. What's up, y'all? Big Herc 916 getting down with Fresh Out. Serving you another edition of old school Prison Talk that you guys love. I know you like it grimy, so you know we had to go back to this old school format because you guys didn't like how we were doing the questions on the podcast. Make sure you guys subscribe to the channel, support. We love y'all. You guys have brought us this far, so we listen to you, and we try to keep an ear to the channel so that we can keep moving along in the right direction. Also, check out the website, www.freshoutseries.com. Make sure you subscribe and support. We love y'all. Had a question from one of our viewers, and actually a lot of viewers ask the same question. Now, I answered this before. Hi, Herc, recent fan. I don't know if you've done a video on this, but as a white guy with a black fiance, would I get treated differently by my own race? And if so, would it be best to try to keep it down low, or does it only matter in prison? Thanks from Canada. Okay, that's one of the questions regarding race. Then I had another one. Hey man, big fan of the show. I'm a Samoan based here in Spain. Just want to know where the Samoans fit in the prison system. Also, which race groups are allies in prison if things get serious? I've had a couple questions in regards to race, and you know, I've had multiple questions about Islanders, and you know, if you're a white guy and you have a black fiance, or if you're a Mexican guy and your wife is black. Look, man, when you go to prison, you're dealing with pieces of shit. Plain and simple. The most racist environment you could ever subject yourself to. So if you've never been at this age, at this phase in your life, don't go. Don't do anything that's going to get you motherfucking caught up. If you're a white guy in California and you go to the state and you got a black motherfucking fiance and they find out, them white boys is going to run something up in you. They do not play that shit. It's a fucking race, super racist environment. Blacks and whites do not get along. The black guys in there are basically doing their own program, and the white guys in there are doing their own program. The Mexicans in there are doing their own program, but they're not mixing like that, man. You know, it's not like on the street where you can go play pickup ball with a white guy or Mexican guy and it'd be cool, or you guys can go to the club together and party, go to college together. These dumb motherfuckers in there aren't doing none of that. You know, they're trying to own a piece of the fucking prison that they'll never own. You know, so you're dealing with ignorant ass conscious. If you're a white guy, you better. And the thing is, if she comes to visit you, you're exposed. So you're fucked, man. So, you know, if you got a black fiance or girlfriend or something, man, and vice versa, just like if you're a Mexican guy and you got a black girlfriend and she comes to see you, and you running with the Southern car, they're going to probably motherfucking do something to you. You know, only once in my life have I seen a black guy accepted as a Sereno, a Southsider, one time in YA. Other than that, I've never seen a black guy, black man, male Sereno. Now, if you're from up north and you got a black wife or a black girlfriend and you're Mexican, you're good. The Northerners accept you. The North Daniels ain't tripping. They on some different time. There's black North Daniels, white North Daniels, Asian, Islanders. It's different, you know what I mean? But California, politically, in the prison system, is the most racist anywhere. I haven't done time down south, so I can't speak on that. And I don't ever want to do time down there. But as far as the system, it's fucked up, man. And there's another guy, his question one time, I don't know if I answered it, but he was mixed. He was Asian and white, but then his dad was white, his mom was Asian. They separated because the dad was a racist. And basically, he went to live with his dad. He got a swastika tattooed on him. But then he's running around with his cousins who are Asian. He got caught up, and now he has to go to the pen for some bullshit. But he's got the swastika on him. I told him, I said, man, the white boys is not going to accept you. You're not white. They want pure white. They don't. You got any bit of anything else in you, whether it be black, Mexican, Asian. You're not white. You're not pure. So when you go to the pen, them motherfuckers ain't got no love for you. And if they did try to act like they were cool with you, they're going to send you on all kind of missions and probably throw you away when they're done with you. So don't get it fucked up. Now, if you're Mexican, and you got black, you're white, you got black, you're black. That's how it is. You can go roll with the blacks. You know, if you're rolling with the blacks on the street, then you can roll with the blacks inside. I knew homies that were white Crips. You know, I knew a cat that was a Mexican Crip. You know what I mean? So it's different. Other races is different the way they carry it. So, you know, that's my whole take on that. And as far as the Islanders, the Samoans, you know, they got an island card, man. The Filipinos, the Samoans, the Tongans, the Hawaiians, they all roll together. And as far as allies in prison, it all depends on what the political situation is of that prison. You know, up north, you know, sometimes, you know, you might have the Crips and the motherfucking North Daniels. They might have a political alliance, you know, maybe along with the BGF or something like that. But it all just depends on where you're at. You know, some institutions, the Bloods and Crips might have a treaty. So they're, you know, and they roll with the Northerners or, you know, it's just different, man. You know, some institutions might be the Southerners and the ABs or the skinheads. You know, they might have their own little thing, political alliance. So it all depends on where you're at. But best believe, man, if you're involved in anything interracial in prison, you're going to catch shit, you know, unless you're a motherfucking OG and you run the motherfucking car and motherfuckers have already, you know, it's already been addressed. Other than that, man, don't go to prison, you know. I know you guys are fascinated with that shit, but ain't nothing glorious about it because you might not make it out alive. Lockdown's over. Get your yard time in. Exclusively at FreshOutSeries.com.